Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 18 of Settlement and Survival. Today we are at, look, we're at County Crossing again. Hey, look, I promise these County Crossing things are going to end. It just so happened that the Mega Bill was in County Crossing, and, you know, I was working on it in the Settlements and Survival, and I got inspired because I needed one more thing, and I finally figured out what it was. So what that thing was another farmer. I needed another settler. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build them a house. I made this house. Basically, what I'm trying to do at this point is experiment with different levels, different shapes, different angles. I mean, I do, you know, go for that that group select, slide it in an angle, floor thing. You're going to see that here in a minute. But this little house came out pretty good. It has a couple of features that I think are interesting that you might find useful in your builds that you might want to duplicate or, you know, hell, improve on, because I'm just sort of winging it here. So today we're going to be building this house. Now this thing comes out, it's going to be a two-floor multi-level structure that, you know, you could use for anything. You can make it a workshop, you can make it a bunkhouse, you could probably sleep six people in here, whatever. But I chose to make it for one person, gave him a sitting area and a kitchen and stuff like that. So now I'm going to sit here and struggle with this thing because, of course, I forget. You can see in the background there that the rest of it's over there. It's basically a bunker and a sort of powerhouse, you know, a little generator room sort of, and a power armor station and some random stuff just sort of stuck on there. But it's pretty small. It's really, really, really small. And you can see over the field there. So anywho, while I mess with this board, we had a very sad event in the last week or two. I killed my second controller. So the first controller that I had that I bought with the original Xbox, because I bought the Xbox One when Fallout 4 came out. I hadn't had any interest in it, the Xbox One before that. And they had a Fallout 4 version, you know, with the faceplate. And I'm like, okay, I'll get the faceplate. I don't use it, but I have it. So I bought that one, and I used that controller until, I think, June. So it lasted, 7 months? So then I bought another one, of course. I always like to have one extra one as backup, because when the controller dies, I want to be able to, you know, keep playing, because I'm a nerd and I play the hell out of this game, as we all know. So I got the second controller out, and it lasted a bit longer. It lasted almost a full year, just over a year. It died last week of June. So the first controller, I lost the right stick, and the second controller, I lost the left stick. It stopped clicking, and it wouldn't react and stuff. So now I'm on my third controller, and I hope this one lasts a little bit longer. It's the newer version with the built-in Bluetooth, so I could theoretically use it with the PC version if I were so inclined, but I tried playing the PC version, and it's just so... I've been playing the console version too long, I think, and I'm just so used to this UI that it's hard to adjust, hard to switch between them. So here's more build order. See, I'm using this thing for spacing because, of course, I want to use the metal thick wall, but I can't snap anything to it, so I have to snap a wood rail to it. So I just grabbed that one and put it back on there. One interesting note that I had forgotten about is that you can snap wall pieces, the thick wall pieces, to the edges of stairs. At least the small stairs. I don't know about the ladders, but the small stairs definitely were. And I'm trying to decide, okay, what kind of thing do I want here? And you can see how this thing's kind of going together weird, right? Like, as I think of things that I want to try, I'll do that thing and then step back, look at it, and go, okay, what do I got to do next? Put the stairway up, the ladder up here, just kind of, you know, soft slide it into there because it won't snap. Ladders don't snap to the edges, they only snap to the front side. And then we'll stick that in. So, of course, it's now starting to rain, so when it gets dark, I think I do sleep at some point here and go back to the thing. But anyway, so yeah, I used some of the mad money I'm making from my YouTube channel, which is, it's a pretty easy number to remember, it's zero. So I got myself a controller. I have a fourth one in the box still. I always like to keep it back up because Amazon had a sale on the colored ones, you know, they got like a black one and a blue one and a aqua one and a one's called Dawn Shadow. It's like fuchsia. So I got that one because, of course, you know, it was cool. I like that. I like fuchsia. There's a little trivia for you. It's our Deliac's favorite color is fuchsia. Yeah, anywho, that was random, huh? So let's stick some roofs on this thing and see what we got. So now I'm like, okay, now I've got this building here. What's it going to be? Right? I'm filling stuff in. I'm like, what do I want to do with this? So check it, make sure it'll clip. Because sometimes when you take those walls off, if the stairs on there are too close, it won't snap back on. So I want to check, always pick it up, check to make sure it'll snap back on. So, of course, do my do the old the build order thing, because we've explored build order many times. Snap it on there, snap something to it, unsnap it, put the thing back, done. So I'm looking at it. I'm like, okay, what the hell am I doing with this? Where is the bed going to be? What am I going to do with the thing? What sort of furniture am I going to use? How is this going to take shape? So one thing I do want to do, I think, is I'm going to put, oh yeah, so I've got a big old hole there on the left. I need to fill this out. And a little thing I discovered here is that when I do these things, if you can group select it from the outside, do so, because it's a lot easier to sink when you have a sinkable surface. I used to take these things and try and use a wood post and place them from the inside, but it's a lot easier to see the gaps. It's a lot easier to see the walls, the edges. Like this thing here, when I go to put it in, I got the stairs. I think I got the stairs in there right now. And I'm unsure at this point whether the stairs are going to interfere with the clipping of this particular item. So I leave the stairs in first to check. I'm okay. How far can I get this thing in? At this point, what I'm really doing is I'm looking at the floor to see how low it is. And then I'm looking at the very edge of the screen where you can see the edge of the wall, right? I'm trying to fill that gap. That's my entire focus right now, is filling that gap. And okay, it's not gonna work. So we pull the stairs out, because the stairs are very snappy. They're like, you know, warehouse pieces. They will snap to where you wouldn't think they will. They sort of ignore their edges when you snap them. So now I'm trying to put it in there, match up the edge, so there's no gap. It's a little bit crooked, but hey, good enough. And the stairs snap back in. So now we got this, I'm like, okay, what am I gonna do with this? What's this gonna be? Let me put some stuff down really quick, put a rug down or two, and start dropping some furniture, sort of eyeball it, see what I can make out of this, and see what makes sense. No, I'm not gonna use that. What am I gonna do? What's it gonna be? What's this gonna be, is anybody's guess. So, while I'm working on this, while I'm puzzling this out and thinking it through, trying to, because I do this a lot. You know, I put placeholder furniture down in structures that I'm building if it's a single structure, so I can get an idea of what the function is, you know, what the purpose is. And we're going to give the settler a bed on the deck there. A nice elevated little thing so the person can just crawl right in bed. Now here I place something that is not available in vanilla that I thought was the longest time. It's these stoves, right? Turns out Art of Blossoming and Insane Chuckledor pointed out that this thing is not available in pure vanilla. And I'm like, but I'm not running any settlement mods on this character. I'm running like the ragdoll, the realistic ragdoll, so bodies don't go flying all over the universe when they die. I'm running the low-res textures. I'm running stuff like that, you know. But I'm also running the unofficial Fallout 4 patch, which fixes a lot of issues in the engine, a lot of, you know, missing pointers and, you know, erroneous sanity checks and stuff like that. It fixes a lot of the under-the-hood stuff, right? Well, I did some research, and I loaded up a regular vanilla character, and turns out those stoves are not there in a never been modded pure vanilla character. I was like, okay, which mod is doing this? Because I don't have any settlement build mods. Pro tip, it's the Fallout 4 patch, the unofficial patch. Something they changed in it changed a pointer in the settlement menus, and that pointer puts those stoves in there. So in theory, the stoves should be available in vanilla, but they're not because of a bug. So that's something I learned about that. So there you go. That stove's going away. After they told me, I took that stove out and I put the regular cook stove in there. So that worked out. And then we're gonna do the table here and put the stove back. And there it goes. So after this, I'm working right now on County Crossing. I'm very much working on it on the mega build. Filling in the gaps, doing the stuff, doing this and that, whatever. And it's coming along. I forget how long it takes to fiddle things. So that's going to be coming next week or two, hopefully. And so now that I've got the basic stuff sketched out, I got the kitchen, I got the seating area, I got a table in there for them, and I've got the bed. Now it's time to fill in the gaps on the outside. I'm really liking using junk walls to fill in the gaps instead of posts. Now here's another tip. When you're trying to place these things and line them up, go inside the building. Because you can see, it's a lot easier to see the corner, it's a lot easier to see the edges, you can see what's going on. And if you look on the bottom left there, the place button lights up when you can place it. So you don't have to see the actual rug to know it can be placed. So I do that and then I'm like, okay, I need to fill the gap on the other side. So I'm gonna do my normal, you know, do this thing here, double up on the railings and stick it in there. Another thing's coming up here. The whole pull the thing off the rug, off the camera, then drop it. I learned when I was playing with this, a trick to that as well. When I was doing it in County Crossing, when doing the mega build, I was noticing that about half the time when I tried it, my stuff would jump up. All of a sudden it was jumping up. And I'm like, why is it jumping up all of a sudden when it hasn't been in the longest time? It turns out that the trick is when you take it off the rug and spin out of view of the camera, make sure when you let it go, it's red. Because what was happening is I was taking it off and I was spinning around and the rug was, the item was touching the ground and it was green, right? So when I let it go and I pulled the rug out, it would jump. But you see it was red there? Now it stays still. I don't know if that's a hard and fast, I don't know if that's a guarantee, but I tested it at County Crossing like 15 times and every single time, if it was green, it would jump. If it was red, it would not. So that's something you can use. That may be a piece of information you can use in your build, in that wait for it to turn red and drop it when it's red, not when it's green. So we're gonna fill in the backside here again. And of course, this is the fastest, easiest way to plug those holes. You know, it looks more solid, I think, more robust, and it looks, you know, junkier too. It definitely looks more haphazard. Another thing I'm gonna try to do going forward is, like you see here, is I'm gonna try and overlap the pieces onto other pieces. So they're not all just, wall width. They're kind of half, they're blended, they're sort of like that. Because that tends to give you a little more visual variety, I think. And it gives you a little bit more, realism, verisimilitude, I don't know, something like that. So now I've got that thing up and I'm like, okay, what am I gonna put underneath here to prop it up? Because I've already used two junk walls and I'm like, God, do I really wanna keep using junk walls? Let me try a piece of furniture. Yeah, that's not tall enough. Out of hell, let's just grab a junk wall as I'm thinking. Let me grab a junk wall. Why not? Grab another junk wall. We'll grab a flat one this time instead of the corner one. And the tire one, you know, the tire one's really tough to use for buildings. You know, it sucks when we only have like three different kinds, you know. But the tire ones are good for external walls. They're not so good for internal walls, unless I guess you have a huge building and then it kind of makes sense. Or an external, like the building faces the edge of your settlement or it's part of your outside security wall or whatever. So now we're testing. This one here, I don't go inside to check how it looks as I'm placing it because I want to see what it looks like on the outside. So I place it and I look in and see what's sticking through and go, is that good? Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, there we go. That straightened it up. And we got enough stuff in there, enough clutter in there to make it look good. Do that, drop it, and can't get it because it's underneath the furrow there. The furrow sticks up too much to do it. So then I'm like, okay, let me put something on the bottom here. I already used a wood railing, so let me use a picket fence railing, see what that looks like. So I look at the picket fence and I'm like, you know, what if I use a gate instead? Open the gate, check it, all right. It opens up this way. I always forget which way the gates open. I always got to check them. So we do this, we put a gate down there, and all of a sudden, look at this. We accidentally have a little storage cubby, so to speak. Somewhere where, I guess, the settler could put tools. You can make a little panic room, like if they get attacked, they could jump in there. So now that I want to make a shed out of this or whatever, I got to put some on the back, and that, of course, is going to be another one of the wood railings, and I put the concrete thing away by mistake, because of course I did. So yeah, this one here is probably, I mean, in a way, it's pretty close to being finished. I mean, I've got the bulk of the main settlement done in terms of, you know, her functional stuff. And then this is for another settler who I got a beacon, turned it on, and I gave him a little patch of, adhesive material because I've got, oh my God, I got so much razor grain. I never had to plant razor grain again. Whenever I go to make food now, I've got like 1,100 dirty water and like 1,400 razor grain. So yeah, I'm good on razor grain. I don't think I need any more. Because I mean, every production settlement I've got, that's all they make is razor grain. Got that done, now we dress this place up a little bit more on the inside. And put some random furniture down, put some random stuff down, try and make it work. I always like doing this for the sitting area. Put that little accent rug down and then stick this thing on there. Because in a pinch, if it doesn't fit, I can always just, you know, pull the rug out, stick it on the rug, slide it back in where I want, and it'll work. But in this case, it works pretty good. So we got that. We got a little prep table for the kitchen. We've got a little lounge area. Got a little table they can store stuff. You don't really need a lot here. And then she doesn't really have a lot of place to put clothing, so we're going to give her a dresser. The settler, of course, is, I guess, you can tell it's female. The female is a female settler that I attracted. Now, this is the downside to those thick walls. Shelves and paintings and stuff don't work. They float. It just looks like crap. But on the other side of the coin, one nice thing about them that I found out when I was replacing that stove with a cooking station is that since they're deep, you can put cooking stations and other workstations much deeper into the wall and it won't stick to the other side, which, you know, might be useful if you want to do build with thicker wall. You can just stick the stove there. And okay, yeah, let's go to daytime. So what am I doing now? Oh, now it's time to, plant the food. Yeah. So a tip on doing this thing here. What I used to do when I was making fields and crops and planting things is I would build the enclosure, right? I would take the fence, because I pulled down all the fences around the field, so I've just got all this material in the workbench so I can just use for free. What I used to do is I used to build the entire enclosure and then put the plants in it. Right? Makes sense. It's logical. But the thing when you do that is a lot of times you'll put the plants too close to the fence and your settlers will be doing their work outside the fence. Like they'll be working through the fence and it looks strange. So what I do now and what I've been trying to do, which seems to be working a little bit better in terms of making your settlers look not insane by reaching through a wire fence to hook a potato or to, you know, dig weeds, is to put a guide up there, a piece of fence that says, okay, this is the outside boundary on this edge, like this thing here. Then I plant all my crops where I want in the thing, and then I just build the enclosure around it while leaving enough space outside it for it not to look silly. And that space is usually about half of a fence section, right? That's about the width, is half a fence section, as a general rule of thumb. As long as the closest plant is more than a half a fence width away from the fence, they will almost always stay inside the fence to work on the thing. So, like again, that's not a hard and fast, and that thing's too close. She's gonna work the mute for outside. That's okay, whatever. I didn't learn it until after this. And again, we put this fence up here, and we don't line it up because I don't want to put a gate up here. I just want to leave it open. And I'm gonna put a Brahmin. There's gonna be a Brahmin in here There's currently a Brahmin in here. I built a Brahmin pen once I lured one in here. But I didn't think to set up the cage before I started building this. But yeah, that's a big enough opening for them to get in and out. Because pathing is tough, man, sometimes. I mean, I'm noticing that on the mega build. I've got so much crap that it's terrible. It's just awful. And, okay. So now it's daytime and I need lighting. So I'm gonna do my standard, put the lanterns on the poles, on the fence posts, because I like that. We'll do the same trick. We get really close to the fence post, look straight down so I can see the top of it, put it in the red, slide it up to where it's centered, right? And then just lift it straight up until it turns green. Boop, now you know it's centered. Because I had the worst depth perception here, man. Stuff's sticking off sideways. I got to place like four different times. So we're going to stick a couple of lampposts here, a couple of lanterns out here, and then we're going to grab, I think I'm going to light it. I think I'm going to give this thing some electricity. I've only got 13 power, you know? And that's mostly because I had to have 10 power for the 5 missile turrets I got. Because I got tired of not having them. Now we go take a tour around. What does it need? What am I looking at? What am I thinking about? I get the pillar back out. What am I doing here? I'm looking at tables. Why am I looking at tables? Oh, all right. I was just talking about defense and I'm like, yep. So my brain works the same way. Mark 5 in the main area, mark 7 on the corners. Again, the turrets, where you build the turret matters. And I'm talking about defense, and I'm like, well, yeah, this place needs a little bit of defense on its own. Not much, just a little bit. And I do have that little area by the, where it bends to fill in, where those floors are weird. So let's just go ahead and stick a turret peeking over the side of the wall there. Yeah, that'll cover the back corner. That'll be good. And if she's sleeping, the turret going off will wake her up, because, yeah, it'll wake her up for sure. And see, now I'm looking, I'm saying, okay, see how dark it is in here? Even in the daytime, it's dark. So I'm like, okay, let me go and get some candles and these things here. And of course, I immediately forget the stuff floats on these walls. So of course, And then I try to place it on this one, but the geometry on that particular wall is just terrible. It doesn't want to play nice with just about anything. It's like, I ain't going to fit there, I ain't going to fit there. What am I going to do with this thing, man? I'm going to put it on the other one? Yeah, let's try this other wall. Because of course, this wall isn't bent. Eh, that's good enough. So we got that one out. Let's go ahead and stick a... Now, for some reason, those street lights don't emit light the same way in every location. I'm not quite sure why. I haven't figured it out. But they're always kind of hazardous to use, kind of random. Give her a trash can, need more light over here in the chill area. And I'm like, okay, it's too dark. I need light. Where am I going to put the conduit? I'm going to put the conduit. I'm going to bury it. No, I'm not going to bury it, but I'm going to hide it, right? Push it as far into this corner as I can. Because when the wire goes underground, you can't really tell where it's at. And I'll remember where this is by where it emits light. So I'm looking down so I don't show y'all what's going on here. Here's my generator. There's my net. There's my nest. Here's my glitch spot there. And it sticks to the fence, but who cares? It's fine. Now we need some light in the kitchen here. What am I going to use? I'm going to use an electric light, but which one? That one? That one's really bright. Let's try this one first. Not quite bright enough. A little bit too formal for a kitchen area. Let's just use the crappy one. Yeah, it's good. We'll put it over here and rotate it so it sticks. Yeah, that'll be fine. That'll be fine. And that's it. Okay, so let's do a final walk around here of this little beast. And you can see what we've created here. We've got a little cubby hole down underneath there. We've got a bunch of crap sticking up on the sides. It looks fairly good. It's got a couple of levels. It's off the ground, so, and it's got multiple access points, so settlers will get in and out of it very easily. We've got 6 units worth of food. When our settler comes in, we'll put them right to work. They'll stay on this side of the settlement. And so, yeah, there you go. There's something you can build in about, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, you know, because you won't be thrashing around like I am trying to figure out what the hell it is I was trying to do in the first place. And maybe this will give you some ideas. Maybe it'll help you build little crap shacks for your settlements, if that's the sort of thing that you like. And there's my turret. So now we're going to go back out front. Yeah, it's going to need to be dressed up. Probably put a picture on that wall or something. I don't know. We'll see. All right. So there is our final thing. I want to thank you all very much for watching and subscribing. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.